Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. This is Eddie Marcus, spokesman and advocate of basic human rights for all people. Basic human rights for all people, as it is associated with me, is a title of the ministry that I have. It is an expression of what is inside of me based upon who I am. And what that basically means is that I look at every person, good people, bad people, honorable people, crooks, all of them are human beings the same as I am. And each of us have common desires that are essential, not only desires, but are essential for our survival, every last one of us. And we, by my understanding and information, are entitled, since we are here, for those things. And as such, I recognize that there are so many forces outside that denies us from having those in the measure in which they are necessary. And so I advocate against that which prevents it. I try to encourage people who are being denied that to stand up and do the right thing so that what has been provided for them, they can have. Of late, we have heard some things that's going on in this country that the people are very upset about, and they are expressing themselves in the ways that they know how. And for that, I would like to commend them and grateful that they have the courage to do what has got to be done, especially when we are living in a system, my friends. And I'll tell you this, and you listen to me real well. This nation is full of wonderful people, but the leaders of this nation are led by things that's other than good. They are led by things that are other than good. Some people call them, they say the head mouthpieces are devils, and the ones who carry out the orders and regulations that have been given down are, well, they want to call them little agents, little demons. When you see people protesting because they are dissatisfied with some stuff that's going on in the country, they are protesting because they're dissatisfied. The Constitution gives them the right, but life itself gives them the right to do what they're doing. When you see the Dakota Pipeline where people are standing out there because they've identified some problems that could possibly come from the activity that is being done, and the government, the people in power say do it, they mean we don't care about the people. This is a money-making operation to hell with the people. When you see people getting killed for no reason at all except perhaps their color, and wonderful people don't like this, they stand up and protest against what's going on, and you see cops militarized with all kind of guns, with all kind of military attire on, and they're pushing and forcing the people back. They are saying, you don't matter. Get your butt back in line and where you're supposed to be, because what is what's going to be. That is nothing, ladies and gentlemen, but slavery. That is militant slavery. So what I'm actually saying, since we got a president and the people did choose it because they did not know any better, they thought that just because you had two representatives that were trying to get into this office, because they were both evil, that they had to vote for one. And so they considered themselves voting for the less evil, not recognizing that if the less evil one gets the support of all these people, he will not be or she will not be the least evil anymore. They would be the biggest evil. So apparently we have in office right now the biggest evil in this nation. And the way they're hurting people up, separating families, going through all of these changes to make a point. The point is that they are evil. The point is they have no understanding of compassion and love beyond themselves as an individual or as a family or as a race or as a nation. That's the only thing that they're concerned about. And it begins with them as individuals and it sticks with them as a family and as a race. So I'm saying to you, we are living in hard times. But all over the nation where you see people protesting by the hundreds, by the thousands, that means that the nation is dissatisfied with what is going on, and there is no way on God's earth that these people are supposed to have this stuff imposed upon them, whether they like it or not, or go to jail, or be beat down, or be sprayed with pepper spray, or be just abused because they're human beings who are dissatisfied with what's going on. So, as spokesman and advocate of basic human rights, I'm saying, Eddie, why don't you take a stand? Well, I have gone in the streets with the people who are upset, but I don't go in the streets now. The last one I went to, I think, was at the state capitol at Minnesota. And I was going to drop my wife off, but I saw so many people, I couldn't believe it. A sea of people. A sea of people. So I had to park the car and go with my wife. I had to be a part of this. And this is what I found, ladies and gentlemen. I found that everybody out there came because of a particular reason, which had to do with Trump's herd them up, get them out of here order. But they didn't just come with that attitude only. They came with thousands of different signs stating what their complaints are, stating what they are being dealing with in this life, and letting everyone else know these are our problems. Some of them had to do with health care. Some of them had to do with housing. Some of them had to do with jobs. Some of them had to do with justice. Some of them had to do with all kinds of things that you can imagine. And so I want to take this moment to, first of all, congratulate those of you who are in the streets, to congratulate those of you who are protesting, who have said you're fed up and you're not going to take it anymore. You're not going to let pepper spray stop you. You're not going to let these military guys with all these guns that's forcing this evil down your throat, when you're not going to accept that anymore. Well, that's all well and good. But if I take this moment to speak to you, I don't want to waste my time or yours. What you are doing is a losing battle. All of the people that gets in the streets talking about Black Lives Matter, well, we recognize and we appreciate as black, as a black American, we appreciate, or as a black person, what you are doing. For those of you who are out protesting because Trump is doing some things in this country that does not represent you, we consider ourselves a people with a heart. They said this nation was founded on people who had a heart. They might not have, but the people who came here did. The people who live here, most of them do. They have a heart. They go to church, they believe in God, maybe a little bit differently, but they believe in being kind and nice and wonderful to people. They believe in this. Sometimes it doesn't come out as a result, but they believe in this. And the fact that we have now the whole reverse taking place, it's like this nation right now has decided that it is going to become the most evil nation on the face of the earth. The president says we're going to put in more money in the military. We're going to have the biggest military that, he might not have said this, but his activities suggest this. We're going to have the biggest military that anybody can have, and no nation would dare attack us. Not only that, when we say do something, they will jump, because now we are boss and we are not going to take anything except you doing what we do. What you see us, the cops pushing the citizens around, dogging them around because they won't fall in line. Now our military, when we get big enough, will dog other nations around, push other nations around, just like we're pushing people around. We might not pepper spray them, but we'll use drones to bomb them and kill the old folks, to kill the children. All of these things are low down and dirty, ladies and gentlemen. So you are right to stand up, but you're doing it in a way that you're fighting a losing battle. See, here's what's happening. Sure, we've come together on these particular concerns, but all around you are all kinds of concerns. It is not fruitful to stand up for a concern, a genuine, legitimate concern, but put all your power in it. You might get it carried through, and you might not. It doesn't make any difference whether you do or not. As soon as you get through with that, you got another one. Why? Because you got thousands and millions of different concerns out there. So what I say to you, ladies and gentlemen, is to get smart. Change this approach. Flip this script. Right now, they got you on the defense while they're doing whatever they want to do. Why don't you get on the offense? The offense. Now, in order to get on the offense, you're going to have to empower yourselves. You must recognize that you might have come together on the Black Lives That Matter. You might have come together because you're tired of people being pushed out of this country and stuff like that. That's why you came together. But I want you to look around. I want you to look around. There are a few signs out there for the things that you are really standing up for at this particular event. But there are all kinds of signs. That's your power. That's your power. So what that basically means is that you have to take a second look at what you're doing. recognize that everybody out there has a concern. And every concern that's out there on a poster, every concern that's out there on a placard, that represents power. That represents power. But in order to have that power, you've got to be unified, not just on Black Lives That Matter, not just in keeping people in this here country, but it got to represent everything. Everybody out there with the health care, with the homeless, with every concern out on a placard, that's your power base. You've got to include it. Now, what does that mean? That means you've got to change the system. All of these people are dissatisfied in a system that says to hell with you. But now you are waking up. You are standing up. You are coming together. Turn around, and while you might have your major concern, and I know that it happens that way, and somebody else's concerns seem to be mediocre to you because that's not a concern. You got that met. But you have to recognize that though you got it met and somebody else doesn't, it's just as important to you that that doesn't get a chance to be just like you. You have to do it, ladies and gentlemen. You have to do it because without it, you have no power. With this, you can change this doggone system. Change the system not just to make sure that people don't get pushed out of this country. Change the system so cops just don't be shooting black people. But change the system so that everybody's concern out here is being addressed. Everybody's out here is being addressed. Now, you already know that the system does not care about you. That's why they put the cops on you. That's why they had the FBI on you. That's why they got NSA checking all your phone records, checking all your emails, checking everything you do, got cameras on every corner of the street, not to protect you, but to protect themselves from anything that you might come up with. So what you're doing now, what I'm suggesting that you do, is bring in everybody. Everybody that's out there is just as important as whatever you came together for today. Now, just to prove to you that this nation is inadequate to deal with you, and that any other nations around the world who practice what they practice is the same old thing. I have always told you that there is a right way for everybody to live on this earth as though they're in heaven. There's a right way. The fact that they don't is not because they can't. It's because somebody else says, hell no. They want to control. They want to enjoy life at your expense, and they are getting away with it. So as you bring these people together, as you start paying attention to one another, talking to one another, getting to know their concerns, and what do? This is what I suggest to you. All of you people who are in the streets, go back into your communities. Go back into your churches and get them involved. Tell them you've got to get involved. Don't accept no for an answer. And if that's what they can only give, then go on without them. But you go throughout the community and talk to people. Find out what the problems that people are having. Identify all those problems. We already know the system already knows, but you just know it for your own benefit. And all of you citizens in your cities, you go to your city representatives. They are all part of the same team. Go to your city representatives and present to them your concerns and require them as your representatives to fix them. Require them. Fix your homelessness. Fix your unemployment. Fix your homeless. All of those problems. Fix your people who are trying to go to school. Fix those problems, people who've gotten out of school and can't pay their bills. Fix all of these problems. You ask your leaders, your city representatives, and I'm talking about every city in this nation. You do the same thing in Cleveland, in California, these different states, in the cities in California, in D.C., in Chicago, in Mississippi, in Texas, in Alabama, everywhere across this globe. You citizens, go out there and make a change in your community. Change the thinking of your community based upon your activity. They already know it's true. They just need to know that you're for real. And by the millions of you that's out there, they believe that you're real, but they didn't know that you were embracing everybody now. Now they know. And when you go to those city leaders and they tell you, we can't do this, everybody know they spend more money in the military than they can educate everybody and do everything you want with. But they choose the military because the military is their might. They don't give a damn about you. They care about themselves. So right now, you care about yourself and them, but you're not going to abuse them. You're going to bring them to the level of you, which is dreams coming true for you and for everybody else. Now, when you go to the city and they say we can't do it, then you same people who represent each citizenry of the cities, I want you to take your representatives, you the citizens, take your local representatives and go to the state capitol and talk to the governor. Every city throughout the United States, in every state, go into your governor's office and give those same demands that you gave to the city representatives that they said they could not honor. And demand that your state representatives make sure that these concerns are met. And they are going to tell you that it can't be done. Why can't it be done? Because the powers that be don't want it done. Now, every state, 50 states, and if it's 50, say somebody said they lost a couple of them, I don't know. Or maybe we gained a couple, I don't know. But every state, your city representatives, the state representatives, all of you, take your problems to Donald Trump and his cabinet and his advisors and demand that he meets them. No more are you focusing on keeping people from, he got you sidestepping, trying to keep people get out of the country while he's coming up with some other kind of scheme. Or that he's doing some other things to the Black Lives That Matter, trying to deal with Chicago in a crazy kind of way. Now you flipping the script. Now they have to deal with you. They don't have time to be pushing folks out of the country because they got their deal with you. And when Donald Trump and his people tell you that they cannot meet your demands and try to force you, ladies and gentlemen, you got the power to recall them out of office. Now, let me say this. Sure, they got a constitution up. Sure, they got all these laws and things that's written to protect the crazy things that they do, but you are the people. And you can change the law the moment you, the people, decide to come together and operate as one. You can change every law that's in this country. Every law. Let me say it one more time. When you, the people, come together and those concerns are coming about amongst you and you put your power behind those things that are concerning you right now, which is the system, and you can change every law in this darn country. You bring Donald Trump and all those people over there who can't stand folks, bring their butt out of office. And what you are about as a nation of new people, of people who are concerned about everybody, you can have a representative put in there if you want. But it doesn't even matter because everybody's on the same page. And what are we talking about when I say those things that are coming amongst everybody? I'm talking about peace. I'm talking about prosperity. I'm talking about joy, not just for the man in power or to his elite or the big businessman who spent his time running across, ripping off folks, lying, cheating, stealing for profit. I'm not just talking about that. I'm saying to you, you make sure that all of these things that you desire are met. And when you do that, ladies and gentlemen, some nations, because what I'm saying to America, I'm actually saying to every power on earth, which the power are the people. The usurpers of power are those that's in government. Those are your con artists. You do what you have to do, and you make sure that in order to get this peace and this prosperity and this joy that has been mentioned here, you make sure that those things that are coming amongst you, and what are they for survival? Food. Make sure that everybody in America has food. That means putting farmers to work. Everybody that's in the food production business, they should be thrilled to death because they got all the work that they need. Make sure that they have clothing. Everybody. All of the kind of clothing you're making, stop making that stuff for a dollar. It falls off you while you're trying to put it on. You make sure that everybody has shelter. Everybody in this country got shelter. I know you might have to start off with some hotel, start living, while some of the people who have no place to live but in shelters can get the construction taking place that would create housing for them. Make sure that everybody has access to education for whatever they want to be involved in, that it is unlimited, that it is unrestricted, that they can get the education that they need to be better at whatever it is that they've been given to do. But not only that, make sure that everybody in this country has health care That includes dental care. Make sure that everybody got health care. Now, I said a mouthful right now because there's so many other things that people are interested in, like transportation, whether it's flying or on water, in cars, or just on bikes. All of these things are involved. There are so many other things that people are doing with technology. All of this is inclusive for the benefit of the human race. So you make sure that these things can be granted to the people. I know many of you saying how that's going to be done. I know you people out there in business who spent your whole life ripping folks off trying to get you a bottom line. I know you're saying it can't be done. But the master of this created earth, the master of this created human race has a plan. That plan has never changed. And what is that? Is that every individual have a career of their own choosing. You're not just here on this earth to be walking around with nothing to do, wondering, what can I do today? It's so dead. No, my friends, you were sent here, brought here, put here to have a hand in what is going on. So with the systems as they have been designed, or should I say the institutions that have been designed, they have been designed based upon what people need to survive. Now, whoever's choosing their careers, there are going to be an overwhelming amount of people who are delving in all kinds of these various careers, which means that you who are in these careers won't have to be working all the time. You can work some while other people are working some, and then others are working some, and you're coming out doing other things, enjoying your life. Your life is supposed to be more than just going to work 8 or 40 hours a week, come back home for a few days. That's not life. That's a slave. So you make sure that these things are met by putting everybody to work. And ladies and gentlemen, the designer of this peace, the designer of this prosperity, the designer of this joy did not require $1, not one quarter, not one penny. Not one penny. Not one penny. So no one could rip you off. Oh, there might have been a time and place and while people were so ignorant and uninvolved and uneducated, there might have been a time when they thought that money had a purpose. And then money might have had a purpose, a genuine purpose when it started out. Like the splitting of the atom had a genuine purpose. They were talking about energy, but they ended up with bombs. So they're talking about making sure that your materials, your commodities, or whatever you might have can be better served by using money. That might have been an intent. But right now you got billionaires, you got millionaires, you got trillionaires that tell you that the con is real and it is alive. But you've got the power to stop it. So I take this moment, I take this hour to talk to you about flipping the script. I take this moment to talk to you about stop repeating yourselves, because what you're out here for now is basically the same things you were out here for last year and the year before and the year before. And if you don't change the system, you'll be out here the next few years to come and then the next few years to come until the world comes to an end. But the power to change it is in your hand. But it means you might have to change your heart, because though millions of you are out there talking, coming together for this one particular concern, which is Black Lives Matter, or what Trump is trying to do to people. You might all come out there for that. And while you're out there for this, each of you got your same common concerns. And you're hoping that people can see it and that they would embrace what you are concerned about. And I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, the key is for you to stop, take a moment, and think about it, and look around you, and see how many people are dissatisfied. And recognize that they have a right to be dissatisfied just like you. And since they have the right to be dissatisfied, since they have the right to stand there and protest and raise sand, that you, all of you, are there for the same reason. A system that is destroying the life that you wish you had. And the power to change it is in your hand. And when you find out that the city, that the state, and the federal government does not care a thing about you beyond, as Michael Jackson said, beyond what they can use you for, then now you are free to stand up, because you don't have to be bound by anything that's trying to take you down. And you got power, because all of the people of this nation want the same thing, even though they're not out there in the streets with these that are there. They want the same thing. And together, you cannot lose. So I come here to tell you what the message is from that unseen power that you can't see, but was responsible for building this whole big earth, whether it's round or flat, who's responsible for the seas and the trees and everything that the earth is able to do. I am here to tell you from that power that if you want to change things and be respectful of one another, you got that power and you can change this. Now, I'm not telling you anything but the absolute truth. And for those folks who are going to church, they are really making an attempt to be closer to God. Some of them are, not because they go to church, but because their hearts have been changed. Many of them go to church just for tradition. Let us not attack these people, because they need to be led down a right path. They need to be led down a right path, and people who are trying to get their hearts right will recognize the right path and will follow that path. The reason that folks went to the polls and voted for Donald Trump is because there was nobody standing up giving them an alternative. And if it were, they were so quiet that they could not be heard. So ladies and gentlemen, I want to end here to say, you want to win, you better change your thing from Black Lives That Matter. Change it from saving people from getting put out of the country, and change it to change the system within this country, to address the concerns of all the people and create peace and prosperity and joy amongst us here in America. And once we've done that, we do not have to worry about any outside forces that will come and attack us, because they, all of the people, want to be just like us. Okay? Thank you so very much for this, your time. Eddie Marcus. Bye-bye.